back to our third class. I hope all of you fine. Hope you are safe at home. Today we are going to discuss I Stand With You Against the Disorder. I Stand With You Against the Disorder is an autobiographical article by Janet Armstrong. It posted in yesmagazine.org. This article was adapted from Paradigm Voice. Indigenous people's resistance to economic globalization. In this article, Armstrong points out the destructive effects of global economy. The objectives of the article is her declaration of solidarity against the violence of cultural imperialism and the Western concept of development. Janet Armstrong was born in 1948. On the Okanagan Reserve in British Columbia. She is a writer, sculptor, educationist, and an indigenous civil rights activist. Slash is her first novel. She is the first Native woman novelist from Canada. Her main objective in writing was to educate young people about Native culture and history. She is proud of her heritage. She is proud of her brown skin and native philosophy. She condemns the Western philosophers and their educational objectives. Armstrong has an optimistic outlook and she communicates it to the people. She thinks it is possible to establish a connection between the Aboriginals and the Europeans. Aboriginals, Adivasigal. She thinks the best thing to do that is to bridge the difference between them. She believes democracy should protect every single person. She thinks communities like hers become cheap labor force. They also become victims of privatization of land and thoughtless exploitation of resources. The westernization of undeveloped cultures is only a pretext to find new markets. She believes that individual creativity involves larger community obligations. Along with the individual, the community must also be elevated. She is a professor of Indigenous studies. Her research directly contributes to the empowerment of the Okanagan community and other indigenous communities. She began her literary career by writing a poem on John F. Kennedy. She has written two novels. Slash is her first and most famous novel. This is regarded as the first novel by a First Nations woman. Breathe Tracks is an anthology of poems published in 1991. Her second novel, Whispering Shadows, was written in 2000. All My Relations, an anthology of contemporary Canadian native fiction, is a collection of her short stories and two children's books.
The passage starting with, I'm from the Okanagan. Okanagan is a region in the Canadian province of British Columbia that is very dry and hot. The two rocky mountain ranges around Armstrong's birthplace are the Cascades and the Selkirks. The two mountain ranges are Cascades and the Selkirks. The Columbia River runs through the land. Which is the river runs through the land? Columbia. Her mother is a river Indian. The Kettle River people are in charge of the fisheries. Which tribe in charge of fisheries? Kettle River people. Her father is from mountain people. They were hunters. She associated with her father's side. Her name passed from father's side and is her great grandmother's name. She believes she has a right and a responsibility to the river because her mother belongs to River Indian. When she introduced herself to her own people in her own language, she described these things. because it tells them of her responsibilities and her goal. The Okanagan word of ourselves mean the one who are dream and land together. Ourselves mean the one who are dream and land together. Dream is the closest word that approximates the Okanagan, but it does not mean dream. It means the unseen part of existence as human beings. It may be the mind, the spirit, or the intellect.
സ്വപ്നത്തിന്റെ അർത്ഥം മനുഷ്യനായുള്ള നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതത്തിന്റെ കാണാഭാഗം എന്നാണ്. അത് മനസ്സാകാം, ആത്മാവാകാം, ബുദ്ധിയുമാകാം.
The dream parts of ourselves, forming our community. This word refers to us being tied into everything else.
നമ്മളെ മറ്റുള്ള എല്ലാമായി ബന്ധിപ്പിക്കുന്ന, സമൂഹത്തെ സൃഷ്ടിക്കുന്ന നമ്മുടെ ഭാഗമാണ് സ്വപ്നം.
Without that deep connection to the environment, we lose our place and confusion and chaos enter.
നമ്മളും പരിസ്ഥിതിയുമായുള്ള അഗാധമായുള്ള ബന്ധമില്ലെങ്കിൽ ആശയക്കുഴപ്പങ്ങൾക്കും ദുരന്തങ്ങൾക്കും വഴിവെക്കും. നമ്മുടെ സ്ഥാനം നഷ്ടപ്പെടുകയും ചെയ്യും.
The four main capacities that operate together when the Okanagan speak of themselves as individuals are physical self, the emotional self, the thinking intellectual self, and the spiritual self.
Okanagan തങ്ങളെ പറ്റി വ്യക്തികൾ എന്ന നിലയിൽ സംസാരിക്കുമ്പോൾ ഒരുമിച്ച് പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്ന നാല് പ്രധാന സംഗതികൾ:
ഫിസിക്കൽ സെൽഫ് ശാരീരികമായിട്ടുള്ളത്, ഇമോഷണൽ സെൽഫ് വികാരപരമായിട്ടുള്ളത്, തിങ്കിങ് ഇന്റലക്ച്വൽ സെൽഫ് ചിന്ത ബൗദ്ധിക തലം, സ്പിരിച്വൽ സെൽഫ് ആത്മാവിൻ്റെ തലം എന്നിവയാണ്. ദ ഫോർ സെൽഫ് ജോയിൻ അസ് ടു ദ റെസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ക്രിയേഷൻ. Okanagans teach that the body is earth itself. Our flesh, blood and bones are earth body. If we can't continue as an individual life form, we dissipate back into the larger self.
നമുക്ക് ഒരു വ്യക്തിയായിട്ടുള്ള ജീവിതം തുടരാൻ പറ്റിയില്ലെങ്കിൽ നമ്മൾ തിരിച്ച് ഭൂമിയിലേക്ക് എത്തിച്ചേരുന്നു.
For the Okanagan, the body is sacred. It is the core of our being.
നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതത്തിൻ്റെ കേന്ദ്രമാണ്.
Our word for body literally means the land dreaming capacity. Body literally means the land dreaming capacity. The emotional self connects us to larger selves around us.
നമ്മുടെ വികാരം നമുക്ക് ചുറ്റുപാടുമുള്ള വലിയ കാര്യങ്ങളുമായി നമ്മളെ ബന്ധിപ്പിക്കുന്നു.
We use a word that translates as hurt. We stay connected to each other, our land, and all things by our hearts.
ഹൃദയമാണ് നമ്മളെ മറ്റുള്ളവരായിട്ടും ഭൂമിയായിട്ടും കണക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നത്.
The thinking intellectual self has another name in Okanagan. It is not a single name but a phrase that translates as the spark that ignites. The closest to the meaning of thinking intellectual capacity are the spark that ignites.
കത്തിപ്പടർത്തുന്ന ഒരു തീപ്പൊരി എന്നാണ്.
ഇറ്റ് മീൻസ് ദ അതർ കപ്പാസിറ്റീസ് വി എൻകേജ് ഇൻ വെൻ വി ടേക്ക് ആക്ഷൻ ആർ ഡിറക്റ്റഡ് ബൈ ദ സ്പാർക്ക് ഓഫ് മെമ്മറി വൺസ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇഗ്നൈറ്റഡ്.
ഒരു കാര്യം ചെയ്യാനായി നമ്മുടെ കഴിവുകൾ നമ്മൾ ഉപയോഗപ്പെടുത്തുമ്പോൾ ജ്വലിക്കുന്ന ഓർമ്മയുടെ ആ തീപ്പൊരിയാണ് അവയെ നിയന്ത്രിക്കുന്നത്.
ഇൻ അവർ ട്രഡീഷൻ ഒക്നാഗൻ മെത്തേഡ്സ് ഓഫ് എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ we must be disciplined to make all the cells work jointly. If we don't join the thinking capacity to the heart self, its power can be destructive to ourselves and others. A fire that is not controlled can destroy. The Okanagan teaches that each person is born into a family and a community. The action of any individual affects both the family and community. Without the capacity to bond a person is crippled or incapacitated and lifeless. Without the capacity to bond a person is crippled, incapacitated and lifeless. Without a family and a community, one falls apart.
കുടുംബവും സമൂഹവും ഇല്ലാതെ ആർക്കും നിലനിൽക്കാൻ ആകില്ല.
The Okanagan refer to relationship to others by a word that means our one skin. Relationship means our one skin. That means we share not only place, but there is a physical touch. It also connects us to past generations and the generations to come. We are tied together. Our most serious teaching is that community comes first, then family, and then ourselves as individuals. Without community and family, we are truly not human. Just go through the main points.
The four main capacities that operate together when the Okanagans speak of themselves as individuals are the physical self, the emotional self, the thinking intellectual self, and the spiritual self. The Okanagan treat the body as sacred. It is the core of their being which permits the rest of the self to be. They consider it as the great gift of their existence. The word for body means the land dreaming capacity. The Okanagan word for ourselves mean the one who are dream and land together. The thinking intellectual self has another name in Okanagan. Our word for thinking, logic and storage of information is difficult to translate into English. The words that come closest in my interpretation mean the spark that ignites, the spark that ignites. We use the term that translates as directed by the ignited spark. To refer to analytical thought, in the Okanagan language, this means the other capacities we engage in when we take action are directed by the spark of memory once it is ignited. Heart is the meaning of the Okanagan word that refers to relationships. It is a capacity to form bonds with particular aspects of our surroundings. We say that we as people stay connected to each other, our land, and all things by our hearts. The Okanagan referred to relationship to others by a word that means our one skin. This means that we share more than a place. We share a physical tie that is uniquely human. It also means that the bond of community and family. We are tied together by those who brought us here and gave us blood and gave us place. Our most serious teaching is that community comes first.
Answer to the following questions.
Answer the following questions in one word or a phrase. Name the river that flows through Okanagan. Second question. To which ethnic tribe group does Armstrong's mother belong? Third question. What is the meaning of the Okanagan word that refers to relationships? Fourth one. Which tribe is in charge of the fisheries? Last question, Okanagans teach that the body is dash. Answer the following in one or two sentences. First question, what are the four main capacities that operate together when the Okanagans speak of themselves as individuals? Second one, what does the Okanagan word for ourselves mean? Third one, how do the Okanagans treat the body? Fourth one, what word comes closest to the meaning of thinking intellectual self? Fifth one, what are the two Rocky Mountain ranges around Armstrong's birthplace?
I think all of you get an idea about Janet Armstrong and her article, "I Stand With You Against the Disorder." Let me conclude. Read the test book and make notes. Keep safe. Thanks for watching me. Have a nice day.